I'm doing an internship in Shenzhen, China at Tencent. Tencent is one of the largest tech companies in China.
Brazil is a huge player in the global community. If you look at their matrix of energy, it's almost entirely made up of renewable energy.
Right now, my research at the space program here in Japan is focused on this one part of the engine in one of the rockets.
I ended up getting connected to Johannesburg and specifically the Makers Valley Collective through a recent alum from the planning program, and was really intrigued by the idea of working and studying how creative economies could actually be a sustainable method of looking at development.
We are attempting to rear giant Triton snails because they've never before been reared, and they are one of the only known predators of the crown of thorns starfish, which devastates the Great Barrier Reef.
The project that I'm working on is looking at ways to add value or reinforce the importance of this EU eco-management scheme.
It's been an interesting exercise in applying what I've learned at MIT to a very specific system, a very specific market, where they have many different research and development areas.
I am working with the Structured Light Lab in the Optics Physics Department. I am also blogging and writing and videographing my experience here in South Africa.
I do a full range from restoring old machia, traditional townhouses, to making new reinforced concrete buildings, not only here, but throughout the world.
I'm here interning with the Australian Institute of Marine Science, and I'm working with their engineering team on one of their robots.
Being here is a completely new challenge. Working with Raspberry Pis and electronics, I've never had to use the word solder or like data sampling rate when I'm sitting in a German class.
By studying the role of the innate immune system, we can further understand why certain livers don't regenerate and certain livers fail and cause other organs to fail as well.
I always wanted to work on projects that are applicable and used all the time in the real world, and cement, concrete, it's the most used man-made material in the world, so I really enjoyed the idea of understanding it at the nanoscale.
This stuff is thousands of years old, and you know, usually you go to a museum and it's very hands-off, but here they're like, please touch everything, hold on to everything.